if you've been unfortunate enough to buy a China tablet, like the Chewy Hi 8, Hi 10, Hi 12, probably the Hi Book, probably even newer ones, I think they'll all be very similar. The Techlast, there's quite a few different makes of China tablets and they're all basically the same. Now, if you've got a Wingman chip as your BIOS chip and you found your tablet's bricked because of the Windows update that forces a firmware update in Windows 10, sorry to say this, but all my local repair shops said Windows 10 does not force firmware updates. Well, sorry, yes, it does. Firmware and BIOS updates, it forces them. And when you reboot, your tablet's bricked. Now, a lot of people don't realise this has even happened, because when they go to turn the tablet on, they just get no power, no power lights or anything else, because its Windows update has automatically updated it. Well, to fix this, the first thing you need to do is get one of these SPI programmers. As you can see there, I've put links in the description to tell you exactly what you need to order and where from. It's got nothing to do with me, so I'm not making profit from this. I'm just showing you where to get them and where to get them at the best price. That's the SPI programmer. This here is a voltage. This drops a voltage. This is too high a voltage. This drops it down to 2.6, about 2.6, 2.8 volt. This runs about 3.6 volt. So you actually need this to go with this device to reduce the voltage enough for it actually to work with the chip that's in most of the China tablets, which is a windbound chip. The chip there marked with a yellow dot. Now, the windbound chip is, I think it's 2.6 volt, where these actually run on 3.6 or 3.8 volt. So you do need this, otherwise you're risking damaging the chip permanently. Now, basically, this just clips into this device. It goes into the last four holes at the end here, so you have a gap of four holes at the front. This bar needs to be lifted up for you to be able to push it in, but basically that pushes into there, the clip pushes back down, and that's everything you need for the programmer and the voltage. Then after that you will need a clip. Now, what the clip basically does is that actually clamps round the BIOS chip without having to remove it from the tablet to repair this fault. Now, all these parts together are less than £20. I actually got the programmer and the clip for £7.99. Even though it was listed at £10, it had spelling mistakes on the listing, which made it quite easy to find and to get it cheaper than a lot of the other UK sellers were charging for it. That's if you could even find one. Now, a lot of people have ordered these from China because I think that's the only place you can get them. Certainly untrue. And I'll leave a link in description. Again, nothing to do with me. I don't make a profit. It's nothing to do with me. It's down to this seller on eBay. But he actually takes offers, so just offer him £7.99 instead of £9.99, and you'll get both of the programmer and the clip for that price. He certainly had no problem accepting that from me. Now, the clip then plugs into the voltage regulator that drops it down to the right voltage. That wants to go with pin 1 to the very front. Push the bar down and all this is locked in place now. And I'll just try and get a better shot of that so you can see actually how that's configured. It's very simple. And once you've done that, then you want to plug this into your USB device. Actually unplug all the rest of this. Just unplug that part, plug that into your laptop or your PC, and install the drivers. Now, when you install the drivers, you can use any drivers off any programmer, really. Just make sure that when you run the software, you're running the 1.29 version of the programmer that actually runs the software to reprogram the chip. Now, like I say, once you've got all this set up, it's quite simple. It's pretty easy to do. Then you want to take the clip. You'll see a red wire running down one of the legs of the clip, which shows you that that's pin one. Now on the BIOS chip, you'll see a little yellow dot or a little white dot. If there isn't a dot, there'll be a groove or an indent in that corner to show you which is pin one. You just take the clip, line it up with the pins. You should feel it actually. It should fit quite snug and hold on to there by itself without popping off. If you do get one that pops off, you might have to order a better clip. But the one that came with this programmer is actually quite good and holds the clip, BIOS pin really well. Once you've done that, then you want to move on to the PC software.